Whoops, it's been a while. What's up guys, I'd like to welcome you to another game Devlog episode. So finally, I found some free time to work on my game, and I'm so excited to share all the new things that have changed since the last time. The biggest problem with the game is, you are alone, just like in real life. This feels quite sad, so I decided to code some friendly turrets that will keep you company. The tricky part is, I've never done such a thing, so you know how it went. The genius I am, I decided not to borrow any code from the internet, and I did all the work myself. Now, turrets shoot at their targets, and you can even change its rate of fire, which will be very useful later on. The turret placement is not thought out very well yet, and somehow, each video I end up with a bunch of cubes in my scene. I replaced the cubes with some bullets and it actually works pretty well. Yeah, I know, the bullets don't really work, but that's a problem for another day. So, now that that's done, it's time to make it look nicer and mess around for half an hour. Well, I think it's time to test them out in a real battle. Okay, I think it still needs some work, but I'm generally happy with the outcome. The turrets were missing a health bar though, so I raised the health bar from the enemies, and it looks nice. I also added something to indicate the turret's ammo. I'll make it that when the ammo runs out, it breaks and you'll have to place a new one. And also, since I do not only want to use pre-made models, I made my own turret in Blender. It is super simple, but it took me longer than it should have. Then I added some glowing materials, because it makes everything look better. And yet another problem, the turret has no max range. Thankfully, I was able to code a simple check distance function and it's looking good. As you can see, the turret no longer shoots while the enemy is out of range. Then, just a little final touch and the turret is done. I think it turned out pretty well for something I made. Let me know what you think. Alright. So, now it's time to work on actually spawning the player into the game. I love what's called a dissolve effect, except I have no idea how shaders work, so...
And it looks really complicated, but it's actually a fairly easy effect to achieve.
Well, somehow I made it work. Brekkie saved me yet again. I even customized it a bit to get the spawn or despawn effect. I think it looks even cooler on the main character. Even the top-down view is pretty good. Now, a few extra effects and... wait, what? Anyway. Now, a few extra effects to make it nicer, and it's done! One thing I've wanted to add for a long time was some loot. I modified the particle system that spawns parts and made the player super attractive. Well, not as attractive as me, of course, but attractive enough. So now that parts gravitate towards him, just like hot chicks gravitate towards me... who am I kidding? Anyway, simply put, enemy dies and you get some fat loot. Then all I had to do was add a simple parts counter which shows you how many parts you have looted. There is so much more I have to do before this game will be done, but I reached the point where I truly believe it's possible. Next up, I will be learning how to make my own UI, I'll be making a weapon upgrade system, I'll be adding new weapons, and I'll try to make some new enemies. Also, sorry if I sounded a bit weird, but those damn allergies got me again, man. Anyway, thank you guys for watching, and I hope to see you in the next one. Oh, and I promise, it will be sooner this time.